Hello, Michael Zalapsky here for Make It Monday, and today we're going to do some fire. Count Cardboard on Instagram made these cool little thing here and said they were trying to recreate these flames with particular or bang, but didn't quite know how to do it, and asked for a tutorial. I may not be action movie dad, but I'm going to give it a go. We've got VFX suite bang here at its default settings, and we'll aim it up because fire shooting up there, and we'll make it definitely needs to be a narrower for sure. Yeah, narrow it up just a little bit, maybe a little longer, and definitely to make it blue. That's the reference, was blue flames there, and we'll say, hey, no displacement, well, just a little bit, a little more than that, 15% on there on the displacement, and not much flash age random. Just 2% here. That pretty much gets us there. Got a little fire going on. The only problem with this is that you can't really have it interact with any other layers. You could switch it to 3D and have 12 of them spin the camera around the scene, but there's no way to make it interact with the helmet without applying a bunch of other distortion effects and trying to make it fit on the helmet like that. Let's not worry about that. Hide that layer, and well, let's try it with Trapcode Particular. I've got Trapcode Particular here at its default settings. Not doing very much exciting right now, but we're going to want to use a light because we're going to use light emitters here. Going to use 12 of them. Make a light, small cone angle, color and everything else doesn't matter. We'll point that light straight up from the center of our comp. So 960 by 540 and 0 on the position. Hit A to get the point of interest, and we'll just shoot it straight up. We will name it Emitter 01. Very important to name it Emitter. And it'll be Emitter 01 through 012 later. So first step on your emitter is to set it to a light emitter. And we don't want the emitter size to be this big, a big old box. We'll make it down to size 20 or so. We don't want it to be uniform. We want it to be directional. It makes it be controlled by the spotlight's angle and whatnot. So there you go. Velocity needs to be a lot faster. We'll set it to like about 1500. And we'll pop here into Trapcode Designer. It's a more fun and interactive way to work. We're going to need the color. Oh, we'll set color over live. And I think there's a nice preset in here that works for us. Yes, electric works pretty good. But for stuff that I'm going to make want to glow later, I don't want it to be all in one color. I need some red and some green. So you've got color information in all the different channels. You don't want it to be all in one color channel or just in two even. You want color information from all the color channels in there. I don't want to be pure white, so I'm going to click here to get a little bit of color, scooch this over, delete the white with a white key. And I want this darker blue to be a little more in here, so get us those ships. I want to make this have a lot shorter life here. Point. Yeah. Point one there. And let's see. We're not really going to see these. I think to make the interaction with the helmet look right, we're going to want to make them some trails with it instead. So alt click here on the aux system new preset. Gets us close to where we want the trails, except that I want no velocity from the parent emitter motion, which is the motion particle from the parent particles. I'm gonna hide the primary system because we don't need to see these trails. We don't need to see them, just need the trails showing up. We'll set the emitter to be from apparent speed, and we'll make the opacity significantly lower, but the size up a little bigger and feather them all the way. See the kind of flame look going on here. And I think they need to have much shorter life as well. And 0.2 would probably be the better way to go. We'll have their opacity go pretty much down, but we'll start this linear preset and just add a little point in here and drag this point down here at the beginning. Yeah, so it just kind of shows up and then fades out real quick. Over the course of life. On this particle system, I think we're gonna make their life a little bit of randomness too on the main system. Just a little bit. Yeah. So it's just a little bit of kind of flickery look to the tip of the flame. And then in the child particle system, kind of more opacity or more particles per second, either way to get a more solid feeling flame. That was feeling pretty good. We're gonna want some motion around the helmet, but I don't want any motion from the displacement to be on the secondary system. So I'm going to add a default field here, and we'll start tweaking the primary system. I think I want a little bit of organic motion added to it. It'll kind of give it a little bit more movement here. So with this turbulence field, make the fade in happen over a lot less time. We'll make it displace not this much. That's too wiggly. Just a little touch of displacement here. So you get kind of a bit of a flamey shape going on there. Then if we add in a spherical field over top of everything, move it up here so you can kind of see it. It kind of pushes around the helmet. No feathering though. So it's just kind of a hard metal helmet. Just kind of interacting here with our flame. That actually works pretty good. Particles go around it. Oh, a little too low there. Particles go around the whole thing. Scooch it up just a little bit. I think that looks better. Yeah. There we go. A little bit of a fire touch on the bottom of our helmet. It's nice. If you want to make 12 of them, as I said, all you have to do is make a whole bunch of light emitters. The easiest way to make a circle would be to make a null object, make it 3D. We'll call it emitter control. I can type. P for position, and we'll just move it over here just a little bit to the side. And then we'll need to make 12, so we'll just kind of duplicate this a bunch of times. Control D or Command D on the Mac. Makes a bunch of different lights, all named nicely. Emitter 01 through 012. Then just parent them to the emitter controls and spin it around. R for rotation, Alt, Shift, Click to get rid of the parameters we don't need to be looking at. Make things neater here in the viewport. With the Grave key, some people call it the tilde key, but it's only the tilde if you hit Shift. So it's technically the Grave key. Anyway, makes the panel wider. We'll parent the first light to it 360 degrees, which is the full spin around. We'll divide it by 12, because there's 12 lights. And there we go. So it's 30. 30 degrees for every light. So we'll parent this second light to it. And it'll be 60. We'll fast forward this so you don't have to watch the rest of it. Next one, 90. You know, add 30 to make it 90. Parent the next one, add 30 is 120. Blah, blah, blah. I'll fast forward. So now if we go to the top view, we've got 30 degree increments, 12 lights all around it. And it makes 12 flames. Press escape, toggles back to the active camera, by the way. There you go. All of them there, and one of them's hitting the little helmet there. If you don't like how streaky this is, you could certainly add more particles per second on your main emitter system. Like 200, maybe, particles per second. And if you wanted to really kind of crunch up that tip so it's not so streaky, even more so, you could even add more particles. I'll hit Ctrl-Shift-H to hide the layer controls here, and hide the spotlights. You can add more particles per second, or you could do a simple trick of adding a bit of a blur, like maybe 1.5 to 2 pixels, 1.5 pixel blur, and maybe up to 3 if you want to. And you just use the levels control and make it work on the alpha and kind of crush it down a bit. You can always add in some optical glow, of course. Makes everything feel nice and hot. Much larger radius and a much smaller size. Like 400 on the size, and yeah, but there you go. It's one way to use particular to do it. You don't have to have the flames be so wavy in the reference. I think the flames are going straight up. I wanted to add a bit of motion there for some bit to look a bit more organic, but I think it needs to be a little more subtle. So we'll go to see all systems here in particular, and we'll go into the displacement on our main system here in the turbulence field, and we'll turn the displacement down to like a lot less. A lot of camera enter a scene here. Okay, we'll hold 1 to get the orbit control. And there you go. 3 dollies in. I should mention, like, all the lights kind of look the same. They are all shooting out the same particles because they all have the same random seed. Under emission extras, you take lights' unique seeds. All of the lights will have their own unique random seeds, so they'll all be very different from each other. So you get a bunch of unique looking little flames there. I should also mention real quick that you can also make flames in Cinema 4D with pyro pretty easily. Got a pyro tag on here, fussed with some of the settings to make the fire shoot up, and got a little helmet, kind of put it in the fire, and it just kind of works really realistically and nice. So there you go. You've got different ways of doing it. You've got VFX Bang, Trapcode Particular, and here in Pyro in Cinema 4D.